All right, what's going on, friends? In this video, I'm going to show you how to change out your spindles on your John Deere lawnmower. Now, this should be the same on pretty much all the 100 series lawnmowers, and all the parts down in the description are going to be what I'm using on my John Deere D110. So I will have these spindles down in the description, and I'm going to try to put all the other parts that are on this deck down in the description just in case some of your other parts need replaced while you're doing this. All right, these are some of the tools that I'm going to use. I got a 15/16, that's for the nut to take off your blades. And then this 7/8 is going to take the nut off on top of your spindles. I use a 10 millimeter. The new spindles I put on there do take a 13 millimeter. If you have like original ones, I think they took the 10 millimeter. And if you end up taking your idler pulleys off, you're going to need a 15 millimeter. I don't end up doing that. And then I end up using a speed clamp to help take off my blades, unless you do have a impact wrench. And I do end up using a torque wrench. And if you want, I didn't end up using it, but maybe you could put some grease or anti-seize on the bolts that go into your spindles. And if you don't have an impact wrench, you're going to probably want maybe a breaker bar, either a really long breaker bar or a shorter breaker bar with either a pipe or a wrench. And I did use some needle nose to help get out some of the cotter pins. And while you got your deck off, you might as well take a putty knife or something, or maybe a piece of wood. Some people like to use wood so they don't scrape up their deck more. I end up cleaning my deck off. All right, that's it. Let's get into replacing these spindles. All right, the first thing you're going to want to do, we're going to have to take off the deck. Oh, also, if you're doing this in the morning, you may want a cup of coffee. If you're doing it in the evening, maybe just one beer, only one. If you have the same mower as I have, this deck is connected on 5 different points. I'll show you the 5 points. We have a deck hanger right here that we have to take off. Now, just remember, when you go to put these back on, they have to go on this way, like this, because you can spin that around and hang it the other way. And I guess in some ways it will kind of work, but this is the way it hangs. So this bolt goes straight up, because if you put it on the other way, it's going to kind of go off to an angle. This one back here, there's another one on the other side. So there's 1, 2, then there's 3, 4, then we have 1 in the front. Right up front there, we got to take all those cotter pins out. And I like to just stick my cotter pins right up here so I do not lose them. Like for the one furthest to the rear, I'll put here, and then I put some right here. And then you can just put that front one wherever, or you can just stick the front one right next to your tire. Put that up there. Get this washer off. Put that up there. Hand. Oh yeah, that one's real easy. Take that little washer off, don't lose it. Sometimes you pick it up with your right hand, it'll help a little. Or if you just play with the deck height a little bit, it'll loosen it up also. That comes right off of there. Make sure you put it on like that, because you can, like I said, put it on. You can hang it like that, but that would be wrong. So hang it like that. Now let me get the ones off the other side. One more pin to pull off the front. I got the 2 lifts and the 2 hangers, and then you got this front, like I said. Now this cotter pin's just a little different. If you still have the original cotter pin, you can see right here is the end, because yours might be indifferent. It might be in the other way. So I'm gonna have to pull it that way, but I'm going to have to pick up on this piece and then just push it that way, like that. And take that washer off. Now all we got to do to take off is our PTO cable. Right here's your PTO cable. So just take this cotter pin out. Now I'm going to take that cotter pin, just lay it up here in the center, and take this PTO cable, pull out on it a little bit. Take it up out of there, just like that. All right, now we're almost ready to pull our deck out. We still have to take off our belt. All right, to take your deck belt off, you're gonna have 2 little hooks right here. They kind of look like they're shaped like a J. Just take that off of there, and then go on the other side and take the other side off. And you can take it off that pulley. Now we should be ready to pull our deck out some. Don't pull it all the way out. I still have to take this spring off. All right, now there's still a spring connected to your PTO cable. To take that out of that hole, if yours is like mine and hook down in, put it up like that, then I push down here and it'll pop right out. All right, now I'm gonna flip my deck over and I'm gonna take my blades off. All right, should be a 15/16 to take off the nuts that are keeping your blades on. Now this is also a good time to maybe clean out under your deck. The more you keep this deck cleaned out, the less it's gonna rust. And you could probably take your blades off and sharpen them. I have other videos on that, so if you wanna see how I sharpen my blades, just look through my videos on my John Deere lawnmower. Now I'm gonna show you two different ways to take these blades off. One will be with a piece of wood and a breaker bar, and the other is with my impact wrench. Now if you have the original blades on here, they're gonna look a little different. I have some gator blades on here. So another thing you're gonna wanna watch when you take these blades off, watch which way they are spinning and cutting. Like here's the cutting edge and here's the cutting edge. But I can put this blade upside down and then you're gonna have a problem cutting. You can also take a piece of wood. This one, I could have stuck a piece of wood right here to keep that blade from spinning. This one over here, I could stick a piece of wood right in there, keep that blade from spinning. All right, now I have a little breaker bar and I can put a pipe on here to get more leverage, which is, the pipe's real easy. If you don't have a pipe, you could also just use, if you have another big wrench, I could use a wrench by putting it on here like this and giving myself leverage. You're gonna have to play with that piece of wood. That's a pain in the butt. Here's another way. If you have a quick clamper, which I like the quick clamps because they do have rubber. This is another way I also do this. I've done this in my other videos. You just clamp that clamp on there. This might be easier if you have one. And that'll hold your blade also. And then you just pull. Well, I'm gonna clean my deck off a little bit. All right, we're gonna take our couple covers off, and that will be a 10 millimeter. Let's take them three little bolts, put them right inside there, take the other side off. This one only has two. All right, now we got these two pulleys that are connected to our spindles, and we got two idler pulleys. I'm gonna put links down in the description for these two idler pulleys. One will be marked small, one will be marked large. And like I said, I'll have links to the spindles also down in the description. And if you want to replace your brakes, these are your brakes right here and here. I'll put a link down in the description to these brakes also. I have a video on how I replace them brakes. Now I'm not going to take these idler pulleys off, but you can spin these. If they don't feel like they're spinning real nice, you might want to replace them. If you want to replace them, they'll be in the description. We're going to take off this belt. All right, this top nut up here is a 7/8. The same way with that, if you didn't have an impact gun, you could probably just take one of your, like if you have a speed clamp like I had and clamp that right on there, that would keep that from spinning. If you pull on this idler pulley like I'm doing right here, it will release both your brakes. Take that pulley off, set that aside. Take this pulley off, set that one aside. All right, my old spindles have a 10 millimeter here. My new spindles that I got are a 13 millimeter. All right, another tip, if your deck is rusted out and this part right here where you have to put your spindle back on, it's kind of starting to get real thin and rusted out. They do make a steel deck ring. I'll put a picture of it right here on the screen. And I'll put a link to that down in the description also. So you could put that steel deck ring around there and just try to use that so that hopefully stiffen that up for you. I do notice that the zerk fitting that's on this is gonna, for at least on this side where the chute's at, the zerk fitting is gonna face the chute. Hand tighten my bolts. I'm not going to use my impact wrench on these because you're just putting this into aluminum, and I wouldn't recommend using an impact wrench. Don't get all crazy on these. You put them tight, but like I said, that's just an aluminum. All right, that's it. I'm gonna put this lid back on. Now this nut right here just needs to go down till it touches that pulley. You don't gotta, it's a lock nut. It's not gonna go anywhere. That one's done. Let me do this one real quick. We'll put that one up under the same way. The zerk fitting is going to be facing toward the back of the mower. And tighten them like I did on the other one. See what I mean? Here's a magnet. That's steel. That's aluminum. Does not stick on it. So like I said, be careful when tightening these up. That, release my brake. All right, now it's time to put the belt back on. Now, if you did take it off of your idler pulleys, it's going to go on the inside of them like that. And I do recommend, if you did replace these, make sure you put your belt down in there before you put your idler pulley on, because it's going to be hard to get your belt on there. All right, now it goes down in through there like that, and then it just goes around like this. Make sure you don't have your belt the wrong way. Like, it's kind of shaped like a V. The flat part's going to go against the idler pulley, and the V should go in these pulleys here. Like so. Now you can put all your covers back on. Me, I don't recommend doing this, but I'm going to try running my mower without these covers on, because I'm noticing that my belt's starting to rub really good here. It's going to wear my belt out. You could try to tighten your belt up. If your mower is the same year as my mower, right here's where you would tighten it up. But good old John Deere got a little cheap on us. And there's usually two little bolts right here, or screws, whatever you want to call them, that you would loosen up and you could tighten this up. So that would tighten your belt up. But I cannot do that. So I mean, I think the only way I could really tighten my belt up is to buy a brand new belt. All right, I'm putting my blades back on. And if you want to know the torque setting for these, it's 65 foot-pounds of torque. You don't want your blades to fall off, or just put them on pretty tight if you don't have a torque wrench. There we go. Okay. All right, make sure you, like I said, you don't have your blades on upside down. Another way of kind of knowing is the part that cuts should be closer to the edge of your deck here. If I would have these upside down, they'd be way down inside my deck. If you're putting your original nuts back on for your blades, don't forget to put that washer on. But them new spindles I got, they pretty much came with a built-in washer. Don't forget, make sure these arms are down like this, not over here. All right, I'm gonna put my PTO cable spring back on there. Before I get that completely under there, you can put it on when you get it under there, but it's a little harder. There, that's hooked on. I'll put this on when I get it all the way under. All right, I'm gonna hook up the front one first because it kind of lines up the back ones a little bit other than left and right. This is easier if you don't have a camera in your way. You can see what hole went back in. At least mine goes in this top hole right here. Washer on, put your little bow tie cotter pin in there like that. Make sure your PTO cable's out here. I guess we could put that on. Pull out, push that in. The cotter pin goes in behind it. should be down underneath all that. That washer on. The cotter pin like should be sitting right above yours like I told you. Put this one right here on. Put that washer on. That cotter pin in. Right there. There. Now just put the other side on. Now I think all you got left to do is to put your belt on this pulley right here. This is what's going to spin your belt or spin your blade. So don't forget that. You got to hook it up over that little J-looking hook on both sides. When you get that all hooked up, I kind of like to go up here and just engage my PTO. Because at least on this John Deere, it's pretty much mechanical. There's no electronic. And just see how if everything went good. Everything looks lined up. Okay, everything looks good. All right, well, that's about it. I hope this video helped you out with installing some new spindles or maybe some of the other pulleys under your deck. And I also have a link to a new belt too, if you need a new belt. Give this video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, and hit that subscribe button to help support my channel. And if you really want to get crazy, you could hit that thanks button down there and buy me a cup of coffee or maybe even a beer. God bless, and have a great summer.